Hello everybody, welcome back for another You Pick the Card draw. So I'm using a couple of decks that I really have rarely used. The one on the left is called the Tarot of Gemstones and Crystals, and I have to admit I have never used this deck. I got it for a Christmas gift a couple of years ago, and I've kept meaning to get around to it, but I haven't. So this will be a first for me. So I'll need to refer to the book because the deck has stones. The cards have, it's nothing like a traditional tarot deck. It has the all the pictures are crystals and stones. So I will have to refer to the book and use that as a reference for the meaning as well as my tarot knowledge. So anyway, with that is the Tarot of Gemstones and Crystals on the left. The middle card is the Voyager Tarot, which is a very, very, very different deck. It's beautiful. The backs of the cards, I think, are just gorgeous. But it's very, very different. It's like very sort of collage-y looking and very, very different. So that is that one. And then the card on the right is the Goddess Tarot. So take a moment and ponder and pick your card, and then we'll come back and get your message for the weekend. Alright, so if you picked the Tarot of Gemstones and Crystals, you got the Ace of Cups, and that is symbolized by rutile quartz. Okay, so I know very, very little about stones, so as I said, I will be referring to the booklet for the description there about the stone and how it factors into the Ace of Cups meaning. But aces are all about new beginnings. They're all about new opportunities and new beginnings. And the cups are a suit all about emotions. They're about our feelings, what matters to us, what's in our hearts, what's important to us. And so this card symbolizes a new beginning in that area. This could be a new relationship. This could be meeting a new friend. This could be starting something new that you really, really love. This could be traveling to someplace new that you really, really love. Anything new that sparks a really, really strong emotion in you. And that always doesn't have to be positive either. This can also be negative, although it's always preferable to think of things in positive terms, right? But, you know, cups are all about emotions, and that encompasses all emotions, good and bad. But aces are very, very positive cards. As I said, they're all about new starts, new opportunities, new beginnings. So I see this as a very, very positive card, a very positive entree to something. So let me just check the book here. I have the book handy, and I'm going to find the Ace of Cups and see what it says. And bear with me because I'm doing this one-handed. Okay, I see coins. There we are. Okay. Whoops. Okay, almost there. Almost there. And of course, these two pages are stuck together, naturally. Okay, here we go. Whoops. Alright, so for the Ace of Cups rutile quartz, it says, "The rutile quartz calms our mind and demonstrates how opposites can be harmoniously united. In the process, it shows us the way to more candor and happiness. It protects us from oppressive and aggressive energies. Placed under the pillow, it guarantees sleep and causes lucid, informative dreams." And it says, that for the tarot interpretation, it says, "Happiness, wealth of feelings, perfection, love, conception, frankness, good prospects, and harmony." Yeah, that's another thing, conception. This could be a birth, you know? This could be anything new to do with love, with emotion, with feelings, with anything that's important to you. So there you go. That is your card for this week. You're about to embark on something new that is going to stir emotion in you, or that has the possibility of stirring great emotion and great emotional potential in you. Okay? So, middle card, Voyager Tarot, next very different deck, is the Seven of Wands. And you see what I mean? It's called, and each card also has a key word at the top. I'm sorry about the glare, guys. But it says courage for this one. And Seven of Wands. So, I think we got the Seven. No, we didn't get that. That was the Nine of Wands last week. The Seven of Wands is all about... It's all about competition. It's all about defending what you have possibly worked for, okay? In the Rider-Waite version of this card, we see this guy who's standing on top of this, like, rocky mound, and he's kind of fighting off... we don't see the people below him, but we see several wands that are kind of, like, stacked up against the rock as if people are either trying to climb up them to get to him, or they're kind of, like, you know, assaulting him with them. And he's holding his own wand, and he's got a very aggressive stance, and he's defending himself. So that makes sense. Courage, right? This deck, to me, I've not really connected with that well. It's just very, very busy to me. There's so much going on in each card, but I'm going to take a close look here and see if I can see anything that sparks my own interpretation of this card. Because to me, the Seven of Wands is all about defending yourself. So it could also be, you know, people verbally assaulting you, people who are trying to convince you that you're wrong, or competition, you know, jealousy, envy, you know, having to defend yourself against people who are nasty, who are trying to throw you off track, you know, and throw you off course. That's what this card means to me. So I see this mask here, this mask, which kind of like, you know, a medicine man mask, or something that would be used in a ceremony, you know, something that would be used in a ceremony for courage. And there's a wand. I see a wand there. And I see somebody holding a stone and this totem pole. All these icons, all these, I guess, things that you could draw on for spiritual energy, you know, or spiritual courage, you know. Maybe you want to perform some kind of ritual or something like that. If you're Wiccan or pagan or anything like that, or if not, if you're just... you know, whatever denomination you are, if you believe in ritual, if ritual is important to you, and you feel like you're under attack by people, and you feel like you need something to draw on to give you energy to support you, then do a ritual. Do whatever ritual is meaningful for you. Or, you know, go to church, go to visit a church, get strength from that. You know, talk to your pastor, talk to a spiritual advisor, just talk to a spiritual friend or somebody who's, you know, whose energy you really admire and who boosts you up and who gives you that encouragement. This card is all about standing tall and standing strong this week. That's what I'm getting from this card. Major, major, major. So if you drew this card, you need to stand tall. You need to stand strong. You need to stand your ground. That's what I was going to say. The Seven of Wands is all about standing your ground. It's about not allowing other people to throw you off track, to intimidate you, to take what is yours, to take what you have worked for. Okay? So stand tall, stand proud, and stand strong. Okay? And draw on whatever, you know, energies that can help you do that. And finally, card on the right, the Goddess Tarot, is the Ace of Staves, which would be the Ace of Wands. So two aces this week. So if you drew this card, you're about to embark on something new. And the wands, or staves in this case, are all about creativity. Creativity, passion, imagination, sexuality, career, you know, it's all about, the wands are represented by the element of fire, and fire is all about passion. It's about energy. It's about what really drives you, what really drives you and motivates you to do things. And so this is about a new opportunity that's coming up. It could be a new job, could be a new idea, some kind of new creative idea that really sparks your imagination and gets you excited and starts you going on some new project, whether that's a writing project or painting or making a movie or whatever. This could be about a newfound passion in your relationship, or meeting somebody new who really sparks that, like, wow, I'm so attracted to this person. There's this amazing attraction between me and this person. You could meet somebody or feel that energy re-energized in your relationship if you're already in a relationship. You could just be feeling really, really good about yourself. I mean, the spring is coming, the weather is getting beautiful, and all the snow is starting to melt. So you could be feeling like you're just ready to get out and, you know, work out in nature, go running, go jogging. You know, you've just got a lot of energy, and there's so many new opportunities out there, you know, and one is coming for you. So keep your eyes and ears open. If you do get inspiration to start a new creative project or do anything new, this card is telling you, go for it, do it. You know, you've got this energy backing you up. You've got this energy that's, you know, kind of spurring you on. So go with it, you know, go with that hot, burning, sexy, passionate energy, and it will lead you in the right direction. Wow. So that's an awesome, awesome card. They're all awesome cards. Tarot is awesome. I hope you guys think so. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please click the like button if you did like it. Subscribe if you haven't already. And to all my regular subscribers, you're so awesome. You're so, so awesome. I love ya. And thank you for watching. And I will see you next week. I'll see you on Monday for our weekly draw. Thanks, guys. Have a great weekend. Bye.